Hi everyone, in this video we'll learn how to print Fibonacci series in Python, and we'll be doing this using while loop. So if you really don't know what is while loop, you can watch my previous video for that. I've explained what is while loop and how to use while loop in that. Okay, so in this video we'll learn how to print Fibonacci series. So let us first learn what is Fibonacci series. Okay, so a series, I'll write the series here, and this series is known as Fibonacci series. So it starts like this: 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, and so on. So if you see carefully, what is happening here is the third number is the sum of previous two numbers. So 1 plus 1 gives us 2, 1 plus 2 gives us 3, and 2 plus 3 gives us 5, and 5 plus 8 gives us 13, and 8 plus 13 gives us 21. So this series is called Fibonacci series. So the third number is the sum of previous two numbers. Every third number is the sum of previous two numbers. So let's see how to do this series. The Python shell is already open, but we'll be opening a new file and writing the program in that. So I'm opening a new file. Now here I will write the logic first and then I will explain. So I'm taking two variables, A and B. So A comma B is equal to 0 comma 1. This is how we can initialize two variables together in Python. Again, this has been explained in the previous videos. So if you do not understand this, you can watch those videos. So here, after that, we will use the while loop. We will write while b less than equal to, now here you can go up to any number you want. I'm just printing the series till 55, so it is up to you till which number you want to print, till which number you want to print or continue. Okay, so we will continue the series till 55 and then put a colon here and then enter. Now we will print b. Okay, after that we will write a comma b is equal to b comma a plus b. Let me write it first, then I will explain this. First I will write it, show you the output, and then I'll explain the meaning of all this. Okay, and now that is it. These two statements are part of while loop. So now the while loop is finished, so we have to indicate this by going back to the beginning, and here we will write print. We can just write done. Okay, and that's it. Let's save this program. File, save, and save it by, let's call it Fibonacci's, and okay, and it has been saved. Now let's run it. Run module. So if you see the output, it is the same as we generated earlier: 1 1 2 3 5 8 13 21 34 55. After that it is printing done. So it tells us clearly that done is not part of while loop. Okay, see, done is not part of while loop. That means done is outside the loop, so it is printed only once, whereas these two statements are part of while loop. Okay, now let's see how we let's understand the logic of Fibonacci series, how it is working. So we have declared two variables, a and b. So let me write a and b here. What is the initial value of a? It is 0. What is the initial value of b? It is 1. So when we enter the loop, b is less than 55, so we print b. That means 1 gets printed, this first number. Okay, now after that we are saying a comma b is equal to b comma a plus b. That means a is equal to b, so a gets the value of b, so a becomes 1, and b is equal to a plus b. Now in this case, what you have to notice that though the value of a has become 1, but it will take the previous value of a when it is doing b is equal to a plus b. So here b will not be 2, instead b will be this 0 plus 1, the previous value of a and b. Okay, so b becomes 1 again. So next time when it goes here, 1 again gets printed, so we get this 1 here. Okay, now in the third iteration, what happens, a is equal to b, so the b value of b is 1, so a is again 1, and b is equal to a plus b, so the previous value of a is 1, so 1 plus 1, that means these two, this, so b becomes 2. Okay, so now b is 2, so 2 gets printed, so we get the third term of the series. Now a is equal to b, so what is the value of b? It is 2, so a becomes 2, and b is equal to a plus b. So in this case again, it will take the previous value of a, which is 1 plus 2, so the new value of b is 3, so 3 gets printed, so we get the fourth term of the series. And the next iteration, a is equal to b, so a becomes 3 and b is equal to a plus b. So take the previous value of a, which is 2, and 3. 2 plus 3, 5. So the value of b is 5. So in this way, it will continue printing the series till the value of b is less than equal to 55. After that, it will, once the value is greater than 55, it will come to this statement and it will print done. So this is how the Fibonacci series is printed in Python using while loop. I hope you like the video, and please click on the like button and don't forget to subscribe to the channel estudy.in. Thanks for watching.